Now, the way I look at oil and gas is, of course, then some people think, is that an industry of yesterday? This is nonsense. In the energy transition, in order to make that work, we have still to make the renewable or the alternative energies much lower cost. And that will take some time. And in the meantime, we all use energy. We have to transport ourselves. So if you look at that way, just the oil and gas industry is part of the solution to go on the paths of transition. And that's where they can play a role. And then every company, every oil and gas company, can then say, okay, I stick to oil and gas, and one day my mission is completed because the transition is there, or I use my talents and my money and my people to transform our oil and gas company to something else. But that is the choice, not any longer to me, but to my successors. I think if we start to go to wait until all governments take top-down actions and then to think that we automatically achieve at the Paris target, I think that is not a good approach. Of course, we need top-down actions, but I think especially cities can already do things today for which you don't need the central government. So it is the combination where sometimes you need the central government to take top-down actions. For instance, a European trading system for CO2. You can't do that as a city, it's useless. But cities can do a lot about energy efficiency or initiatives to integrate heat into, let's say, central heating for the houses or in offices in the cities. So it's a combination of top-down and bottom-up approach. But what I see is that I think sometimes people, to which country should I go to see the best example? Probably it is easier to say to which city I should go to see good examples. You see certain cities, usually with the inspiration of a mayor or some mayors, who like to be upfront in their approach. And one can think about cities like Singapore, Rotterdam, I would like to think, but more, in my expectation, more cities will follow. And then, to take a strange example, even cities like Beijing and Shanghai, which were very badly placed some years ago, you see definitely a path that the population say, we don't accept this very high air pollution. So you will see steps, and I'm convinced it will take some years, but the Beijing and Shanghai's will be much better than today. Again, these are initiatives by cities and not initiatives by governments. If I look at my own experience, for instance, Shell was already nearly 20 years ago. We put already an item for our internal designs. We put already a high price on CO2. It was, I think, in 1998, we put already $40 per tonne as a kind of penalty to CO2 in order to make our designs more energy efficient. So there is for very long, there is an awareness that CO2 is not good. And we didn't know at the time how it would unfold, but the awareness was of course there. And then you see, if you think that through, to be not only oil, but from going from oil to gas was a very logical development. Yeah, what I see at this conference, great awareness of the energy transition. So the what is accepted now, that is the Paris Accord, up to 2 degrees. Now the whole discussion is about the how. How are we going to do it? And that people try to find a path, a long-term path, to make Paris a success. That is the subject of this conference here.